Hello everyone, welcome back. And we are continuing the topic on session 17 with data stores. So in the previous two sessions, we discussed about data stores and shared storage. In the previous session, we went through how to add a new data store or run. And now I'm going to show you how to increase the data store capacity. In your environment, you may find you have VMs running, you have a heavy growing environment, you have a BAU growth where you know you're doing normal patching and everything on your server, then gradually the disk is increasing and all of a sudden you see a alert on your storage saying yellow or you know red saying, oh, warning, you have gone over your threshold and you only have 10% left of 10% storage left, you know. So how do we tackle those situations? So there are two options you get. You either request for a new data store from your storage team or you ask them to increase the existing data store. So this is as increasing asking for a extension or increase on existing data store, and this is how we are going to expand it. Let's get started. So the agenda today: increase data store capacity. How to do it? Obviously, log into the vSphere client, click configuration tab and click storage, click data stores and click on settings. So this is what we are doing here, clicking on settings, and then you'll find increase option which I showed you before. So select increase and select next and then follow the wizard from there. In our lab here, we have this demo cluster and we have some storage attached to it. So at the moment, we are going to try it out on the first 103 ESX host. Okay, so as I said, you'll find a tab calling, a button called increase. And let's get into it and show you how to do that. Now, before even we get started with storage, as soon as you find out that the storage is provisioned from your storage team or you have done it yourself, maybe if you have access to the storage and you know how to do it, first of all, you need to right click and go to storage and rescan storage. So what that does is you can now select scan for new storage or scan for new VFS file systems. So so you can see rescan of all HBAs are done and rescan of UFS file system is done. So that's fine. Once you do that, then you go on this disk data store which you want to expand. In my situation, it's this one, FreeNAS LAN2. Right click and you can select increase data store capacity. Or alternatively, you can go to settings. In settings of that particular one, you can see refresh again, which you can do, and also you can see increase. Once you get here, you will see the same storage. At this moment, my session is not allowing me to select it, but you'll find the storage here and you will obviously get a confirmation from your storage team saying maybe they raised it, they increased the limit to maybe 100 gig to 200 gig. You just see that here as a taskbar and then you just increase it to the fullest or to the maximum and then say next, next and finish, and that's it. That's how you do it. To get a clear view of how it looks, I can quickly show you from a point of view. So I need to go back and select the host again, sorry. So it looks literally like this. Say for example, you selected a name and then you go next and then it looks literally like this. So basically you then choose, it will be like this, you then they go and increase it to the fullest. And that's about it really. Say next and then finish, and when you click finish, it will be deployed. It will be increased, the data store size will be increased. This is basically adding a new data store here, as you can see. So if we are really adding it, we need to name it properly. So this will be 3. There you go, you learned how to add a new data store and increase existing data store. So that's all for today, folks. Now I have 3 data stores presented to this particular host, and if you select this one, you only have 1 data store. That's a bad practice. You need to have all the data store presented to all the hosts. Because this is just a demo, I am not provisioning this from my SAN and a free NAS storage which I have. I'm just adding local disk to it and as a VMDK, because these are virtual ESX host, and then increasing it and showing it how to increase it. Anyway, if you have any questions, you can always come back to me and we can go through them individually. So that's it for now, guys. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button. I hope you like the video. Let me know. I need to hear from you guys. Let me know on Twitter. Ibrahim, my address is at ibrahimquraishi, and most of the content which I'm pushing on my blog, you'll be finding it most of the content which I'm doing on my YouTube channel, you'll find step-by-step guide on my blog, so follow that. Also, I'm very excited about my new blog. Be sure to subscribe, because I will be starting to do curation of the top bloggers in virtualization, so you'll get really latest information and content from them directly to your email, really. So be sure to subscribe. Question of the day today: how do you increase the data store size? How do you increase the data store? So we saw the option, there was a button we need to press. Need to go click on settings and press the button. What was the button called? Tell me in the comment below. And don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing, guys. See you. Bye.